watching. We're going to go through a few things from Rangers game. Myself and Jamie will lead the session. He's going to do the first part. Myself and Crafty will do a bit with everyone else and Chappie, and then we'll ease into the whole thing and then with a 9v9 game. We're looking at how we play off in the back, the decisions we make, and the different rotations we're looking for. Okay, so listen in, Jamie, and do his bit, which is
cool. Just from the get-go, lads, when we get out, I'm just going to ring off some names, and usually we'll be coming to me at first. But first, Matthew and Robbie, usually will come to me for kind of 10, 20 minutes. I'll let Barry warm up, and then the rest of you will be with them, Clarky and Chappie. Alright? So I'm just going to kind of run through what we're looking to kind of work on. Alright, so the biggest issue is kind of being faced while playing out from the back. Both positions need taken up for the full-backs, centre-backs, when we're starting for the build-up play. Awareness, very poor of teammates' positioning and opponents' pressing position. Passing is kind of fairly simple. It wasn't really breaking the line and really kind of taking the easiest kind of options for that. Wasn't a lot of rotation, so a lack of rotation to create blocks of space to get on the ball. That's really kind of, whether it be your midfielders kind of rotating down, whether it be kind of the six dropping in to the kind of left-back position, or the full-back popping in to the defensive centre-mid position, etc. But we'll run through rotations anyway when we're up the pitch. Obviously, to create as much width early as possible to get on the ball quickly and try to catch obviously the opponent out and not recognising the spaces in behind the high press to penetrate the opposition, whether it be an off-field pass into your striker or into your midfield. Alright? So, as I say, so from the Rangers game, it's just five clips, okay, kind of picked out from this game, all from the first half. Obviously, you know the outcome of this game, so we'll just run through it and I'll just talk through it as we go. Alrighty? Yeah, and you can jump in at any stage of
goals. Have a look now in this, have a look at the centre halves positioning, the full backs, and in particular the three midfielders. What's all the rotations and the positions at all times? No point in us playing out if we end up 30 yards from our goal and he ends up in our box 5 seconds later.
Just look how expansive we are as well, lads, from the very start in that clip. We'll just take it back. Look how expansive we are. Okay, now fullback should be up higher here, giving him an angle. Alright. He's in a bad position, but as soon as we lose the ball, we'll just handball in. Alright, we're so wide open, fullback. Right, centre back should be over, he should be tucked in, making it as difficult as possible for them. Alright, plenty of, you've got more composure in the ball there, can we try and even switch it out to the other side, but no, we just stay up the same side and just get the ball away straight away. Alright. Again, full back. Quite lazy, not even facing the play. Due to their high press, they're absolutely snippled. Alright.
And you can see the picture there. If we do that right, if you want to go back to it a second, Jim, if you see the picture of how many attackers they have, so if you let this flow now from the plays out, look how many attackers they have against us as it goes. 5v5, so the reason we're going to work on this is if we beat this press, we're up against it. Look now, look at that picture. So if we are good enough to beat that press, and the reason we're looking to rotate and get the midfielders on the ball is because now, and I don't mean to generalise, but they'll be lazy and they won't want to come back. Okay, but we have to beat that, or otherwise lazy attackers can win the ball there and they're 15, 20 yards from our goal. Alright? That's why we're going to work on this. It's not just to give us something to teach us on a random night during the week. There's a reason behind it, everything we do, okay?
In the ball as well, lads. Like, we just need full back further up here, get him to drive and commit him, but not because there's lack of urgency and movement, goes back to the goalkeeper, and again, they've just got a much high press, it forces us in, their goalkeeper, bring the ball at the back, and our last third. That all came from our bike. Now, just pause here, these last two clips. We're still looking to play it from the back, but these are kind of in open play. They're not from by kits, but again, it's the same principles. All right, and obviously the last clip is all about managing the game as well. All right, I'll speak to you through it as we go. Right centre back, it's just a straight pass into our six. All right, somebody up, he's backside, doesn't know what's happening, forces him to make a mistake. This last one, imagine the game, we're 4-0 down at this stage. This is a left mid. Goalkeeper, 2-8 to start the game, not any options at all for him, goes back to the goalkeeper, before he knows that he's got a striker on top of him. So it's just recognising these opportunities, lads, and managing the game as well. All right? So, main objectives of the session, looking to play in tight areas, working off that high press, working through it, recognising where to play one and two touch passes, playing in tight areas and having that bravery on the ball that we've obviously spoke about when we're under obviously severe pressure, looking to exploit spaces to play into, to try and break the lines of the opposition, alright, and then finally just recognising where to play short and where to play long passes to exploit the high press, okay? Now this is just basically coming from my schedule, okay? So first 10 minutes will be kind of dynamics to footwork. This is mainly for goalkeepers. Then goalkeepers will go out and pass the movements in dimension of the goal area. Obviously Dermot will take you lads for your part. And then it'll be a tactical practice. Five outfielders are going to come to me, plus one goalkeeper. We're working build up, transition to defence, to attack. The other lads will work with Dermot. Clarkie, and obviously looking to work on the press from attacking sense. All right. Then 11 players will come in with Dermot and myself. Dermot will be leading this part, plus one goalkeeper. We're kind of tactical, kind of practice, kind of feed the play type thing, and then we'll all come together for a condition gate at the end with various kind of conditions on. And then we'll have a cool down. Any questions? You all good?
All understand okay?
Aye.
Okay, get yourselves over, go up, and don't let any balls moving, just get yourselves up and get stretching. Can't be continued.